Thank you very much, my valuable friend and all other precious guests and friends, especially our valuable guests from other countries. Thank you very much. Welcome. And you should know that Turkey and Istanbul is your country. You should know that this is your country. You are most welcome here. Because you should know that we are all the sons and daughters of Adam and Eve, and this world belongs to all of us, belongs to all humanity. This world was created for all of us, and we are, every individual in this world is entitled to benefit from this world, regardless of religion, geography, ethnicities, races, different races. Almighty Allah created us all. We are His servants, and we are all equal. We all have an equal share in this world, and all these countries, they are all our countries. They belong to all of us. We should know that. This Mr. Ulrich, he spoke before me. In his country, 3 million Turkish people live, and they have Germany as their homeland. They consider it as their own country. So we see it today. And naturally, this peace, this culture of peace, is not something that the politicians can promote only. It would be naive to say that only the politicians can do that. All of you know, almost for 9 years, I've been a part of the European Security Organization as the representative of my country, and also I worked in the OECD as the vice president there. And I know that this cannot be done only by the politicians, and I know that it would be dangerous if only the politicians worked on that. So therefore, I'm very happy to be invited here. And the latest example to this phenomenon is the relations between Turkey and Israel. Due to an unfortunate incident, Turkey-Israel relations were strained a lot. And by the way, I hope that this can be a means to rebuild those ties between Turkey and Israel. And I have to say that the religious leaders, the Israeli religious leaders, will play the great role in rebuilding those ties between the two countries. They came here through my connections in Ankara. They also paid a lot of visit to me in Ankara, those Israeli religious leaders. And during those visits, we talked about those issues in a very lengthy manner. So what I'm going to say here, we all talked about this in Ankara and in Israel, and I want to answer their questions here too. This is something that can be done by the members of the Knesset, by the politicians, religious leaders, and this will be done with the help of all of them, with the journalists, and especially in Tel Aviv. There is a group of Turkish Jewish civil society members in Israel, and all of these people work together to rebuild those ties between the two countries, and they succeeded. Good friends, you can tell that a friend is a good friend in these difficult days. So I hope that inshallah we'll get very good results. I see this as a very friendly, very good friendly gesture. The first stage of this has been completed. And during our last talks with the Israeli meeting, we just talked about the formula of the apology. So they asked our opinion, and we talked about this in Ankara. And in the second and third stages, inshallah, I hope that they will also be very successful. Of course, I'm not forgetting that I'm sitting next to Yaşar. I know my place, so I'm going to explain it too. We will solve all those problems too. we will also solve those problems. Of course, the final stage will be the most challenging, demanding stage, the Gaza problem. But as long as the sides have good intentions, it will be solved too. I know that this meeting will give very good results, will yield very good results. I believe that. And although I won't be able to be here for a very long time because I promised to be somewhere else in Istanbul today, and anyway, my brother who spoke before me said, speaking short is better, so I would like to heed that advice and welcome, and thank you very much.